And thank you for accepting our invite. So today's topic is moot court versus actual courts. So moot courts has been a part of curriculum for all the law students, and so ma'am, this is an amazing topic. So ma'am, would like your insights on that to start with.
Okay, thank you guys for me inviting me for this session and webinar. And these days everyone know that we are facing the lockdown also, so we discuss the topic very thoroughly and maybe in a large way. And the moot court is like just an imaginary presentation of the court to the law students, where they can understand the court proceeding and where the where the judges are sitting, where the reader, where the almud room is there. And it's like just an imaginary world creating in a courtroom, where people, where the law students, if they go to trial courts, even in the appellate courts, in high courts, and maybe then the Supreme Court. So there is a variation of presentation in the courtroom, so that the student of the law can interact. And after the registration, when they become the lawyer, but they are just a child. For the new learner and the new advocate, it's like a child for the court. So for becoming and understanding to them, the moot court is like a concept where they can understand the basic court trials and the court proceedings. The court proceeding and court trial, I would say it's a very lengthy and very large and daily learning process for the every law student. But as a part of for the proceeding, it's very necessary for the every law student. In my law time, I have also faced the moot court, and the rest of the students will face in the future also. But the variation of the moot court will enlarge in the coming future, because as per the present situation we are facing, as like just because of the virus, we are not able to attend the court hearing regularly, and we cannot face the judges like as the normal ways we were able to do it the court proceedings. Now we are somehow, though I am also presently doing my virtual court proceeding through the my video conferencing, mailing the my all presentation to the judges and contacting to the first of all the concerning person, then we are able to proceed for the further. And moot court is like in a generally a moot court mein hum log kya karte hain ki ek judge ki ek seat bitha dete hain ki ek hamare samne judge sahab hain, aur hum unke samne ek koi particularly imaginary case present karte hain, jisme har student ka ye ek prospect hota hai कि वो अपने केस को एक ट्रायल में किस तरह से प्रेजेंट करेगा, उसके आर्ग्यूमेंट कैसे होंगे, और उसका फाइनल डिसीजन की तरफ किस तरह से परसी होगा, जो कि जज कन्विंस हो जाए कि उसकी जो प्रोसीडिंग्स या डिफेंस है या प्रोसिक्यूशन की प्रेजेंटेशन है वो कितनी कन्विंसिंग है, कि जज उस पर इंटरेक्टली आपको एक डिसीजन देने के लिए कह दे कि हाँ भाई, अब आपकी डिसीजन और आपके आर्ग्यूमेंट्स और रिटन स्टेटमेंट्स हैड बीन कम्प्लीट, और अब आपको आपको इस केस का डिसीजन हम फेस करने डिसीजन पास आउट कर देंगे, देन योर क्लाइंट इज एबल टू गेट द डिसीजन और डिक्री मे बी, बिकॉज हमारे पास में ही होता है कि कई बार हम सिविल केसेस फेस करते हैं, फैमिली डिस्प्यूट्स फेस करते हैं, क्रिमिनल केसेस फेस करते हैं, तो हर एक की एक अलग अलग वेरिएशंस होती है. जैसे अगर आप किसी क्रिमिनल कोर्ट में जाएंगे तो आपको सबसे पहला वर्ड फेस करने के मिलेगा ट्रायल. तो ट्रायल एक ऐसी चीज है जो बहुत ही लेंदी होता है, लेंदी प्रोसेस. उसमें कहें तो 10 स्टेजेस होती हैं किसी भी ट्रायल में, चाहे वो सिविल का ट्रायल होगा या क्रिमिनल का ट्रायल होगा. सिविल और क्रिमिनल में सिर्फ डिफरेंस इतना होता है कि सिविल में आपको एक रिटन डॉक्यूमेंट्स ही प्रेजेंटेशन देनी होती है. लाइक अगर सिविल का मैं फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एग्जांपल दूं, बहुत ही शॉर्ट में अगर एग्जांपल दूं, तो आप अगर किसी पिटीशन को फाइल कर रहे हैं तो उसके बाद में फिर आपकी रिटन स्टेटमेंट जाएगी, रिटन स्टेटमेंट के बाद में एविडेंस प्रोसेस स्टार्ट होते हैं, जहाँ पे एक का चीफ एग्जामिनेशन होगा, फिर दूसरी पार्टी जो डिफेंस की होगी वो क्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन करेगी, और उसके बाद जाके आपकी प्रोसीडिंग कंटिन्यू होती है, फिर उस पर जाके फाइनल आर्ग्यूमेंट होंगे और आपका डिसीजन जजमेंट या डिक्री आपके हाथ में. लेकिन अगर आप क्रिमिनल प्रोसीडिंग्स में जाते हैं तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल तो अगर किसी के ऊपर एफ आई आर हो गई तो हम सोचते हैं कि चलो बेल करा लेते हैं. तो बेल के लिए भी कई ऑप्शन होते हैं कि आप पहले तो सबसे पहले देखो कि आपके क्लाइंट पे चार्जेस क्या हैं, कि उसकी उसकी जो जजमेंट उसके ऊपर जो सेक्शन किए गए वो एनम ट्रायल है या सेशन ट्रायल है, और सेशन ट्रायल है तो उसमें बेल एप्लीकेशन किस प्रोसेस में जाएगी, और अगर एमएम ट्रायल है तो वो किस प्रोसेस में जाएगी. क्योंकि अगर हम एमएम ट्रायल में जाते हैं तो एमएम ट्रायल के लिए बेसिकली ये चीजें होती हैं कि 3 इयर्स की जिसमें पनिशमेंट होगी तो वो आपका एमएम ट्रायल हो गया. एमएम मतलब मेट्रोपॉलिटन मजिस्ट्रेट. मोस्टली स्टेट वाइज डिफर करता है. जैसे हमारे पास में कई ऐसी ऑडियंस होगी जो कि अलग स्टेट से ही प्रोसीड करती होगी, जहाँ पे ना जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट होते हैं, और मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज में होता है जहाँ पे एमएम होते हैं, तो डेफिनेशन उन दोनों की डिफरेंट होती है, लेकिन पावर सेम, यानी फर्स्ट क्लास मजिस्ट्रेट हुआ और हमारे यहाँ पे एमएम हो गए, दिल्ली में जैसे एमएम हो गए, मुंबई में एमएम हो गए, जितनी मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज हैं उनमें मेट्रोपॉलिटन मजिस्ट्रेट ही होंगे। तो आपके यहाँ पे जो मेट्रोपॉलिटन मजिस्ट्रेट की पावर होती है वो 3 years की कन्विक्शन की होगी। तो आप अगर किसी भी 3 years कन्विक्शन में बेल एप्लीकेशन फाइल करेंगे तो 437 में जाएगी, 437 में, जो एमएम ट्रायल के केस में। और इन केस अगर आप सेशन ट्रायल के केसेस में जा रहे हैं, जो 3 साल से ऊपर की सजा के केस है, जैसे 10 साल हो गया, 10 years की पनिशमेंट हो गई या लाइफ इंप्रिजनमेंट हो गई, तो जो सेक्शन उस पर डिफाइंड है या जो FIR में सेक्शन पर्टिकुलरली मेंशन है, तो उसमें आप 439 के सेक्शन में आप हाई कोर्ट भी जा सकते हैं और आप सेशन में भी जा सकते हैं, ये लिबर्टी है। और एक एप्लीकेशन का प्रोसेस एक डिफरेंट होता है, जहाँ पे हम कहते हैं एंटीसिपेटरी बेल एप्लीकेशन, जहाँ पे हमारे क्लाइंट के अरेस्ट होने से पहले हम उसको प्रेजेंट कराते हैं कि हमें एप्रीहेंशन है, माई क्लाइंट विल बी अरेस्टेड बाई द पुलिस ऑफिशियल, मे बी दे कैन टेक अ कस्टडी एंड विदाउट एनी कॉज एंड रीजन। सो ऑन दैट पार्ट वी फाइल द एंटीसिपेटरी बेल एप्लीकेशन बिफोर द सेशन कोर्ट, वी कैन नॉट प्रोसीड to the MM court for the anticipatory bail, whether the section are under 3 years punishment or 7 year punishment. It is compulsory if you are going for the anticipatory bail, then it should be in a session court or high court, because in the bail prospect, both have the same power.
Yeah, but Neetu, we also come across being I was a law student, so I can figure that out. Being a law student, we have not been taught about the practical aspects. We do take part in the moot court competitions. We do take part, you know, we present our pleadings in front of the judges during different rounds, prelims round, quarters, semi-finals and finals. But what we miss out is the actual presentation. Now, in actual courts, we have to draft a notice, we have to send a summons, we need to do a lot of procedures we need to follow.
Right.
But in the moot court competition, what we do a lot of research, we make a complete memorandum from both the ends, and when we submit in the competition. But we forget about mentioning a lot of things in it. How would you, what's your suggestion for our students right now present here? What they should actually focus on, only on the competition or learning the aspect of the actual court and then present their memo to the competitors or the organizers?
You know, Sahil, I have seen number of students, those who are regular to the college and their semester-wise examination. I have number of the interns, those who in their vacations of their college and semester differences, they came to me and they learn how to proceed in reality to the court. They draft a notice, they file the process fee, they face the adjournment, they face the how to file the case and how much court fees is required, where the oath commissioner is required. Because number of things in like a clerical work, if I say, that is the basic thing that you should know about the court proceeding. Because just on a facing like a, we in the board court, we have just an imaginary world, like we are watching movie, nothing else. Where the we saw the concrete of the arguments and the story of the things, like we are presenting a story. But in reality, the court is quite different than the moot court. The moot court is just like a theoretical aspect that should need some changes for the student also. In every semester, I suggest for the colleges also, if they are required, their students should go to real court for the at least 1 month or 2 months for the trial court. And even I personally just told the law student to actually just for the glamour and the higher reputation, student goes to high court for the internship. And they go to law firm, they go to some Supreme Court senior lawyers, where you only learn the appellate authority, where you face just on a bail application and appeal in any matter, where just an argument is required in the proceedings. But every student, those who had completed their law, they should go to trial court for at least 2 years, because the basic process, if you don't know, then you are not able to learn as in a lawyer, and you will want to be in a good lawyer for the any case, because the basic is the for the any appeal, any of the decree, any of the bail application, just the basic thing for your case, which is very, very important for the everyone. And even I personally, I would say, Sahil, I have the number of appeal and some other work, even my scene was also there. But I prefer the many of the criteria of my work in the trial court. From the last 10 years, I am doing a number of cases in the trial court, and somehow I have this some resolved matter and got this some appreciation from the court also. So that I would suggest for the my rest of the audience, if they are coming to the law field, they should go to trial court. That is very necessary, because in a just a moot court, we won't be able to get the entire thing which is required in practical life, because right. It's like a profession and variations always comes. Like we are facing the virtual court proceeding, that is unexpectable for us, but we are absolutely doing right these days.
Right. So how actual courts are differ from virtual courts? I mean, call on that?
No, actually very, very, very much different from the actual court to virtual court, because in daily routine work, like we interact to reader for the miscellaneous things. Like if we are not able to get anything, connect to the reader, and filing, we go to filing window. We get for the filing of any application, we get the some stamp required for the filing of application, some oath commissioner required for any of the document. Now these days, all these things has been exempted, because no one is able to purchase the court fees, and practically they cannot file the bail application or any of the plaint through the directly for the window. So that in these days we are exempted from the attestation and any of the stamp required. We just need a PDF file. We file to the court, and one concerned person is required between the judge and the lawyer. For the concerned person, we connect to the call, and they give me a time, like a particular time the judges are able to connect you through this. And I have to argue on my online, and I'll get my order on my mail. And in reality life, that like in a normal days, for the getting an order, I have to file certified. I'll get the at least 15 or 40 days for the getting the certified copy. So somehow it's quite easy for me. But on the some other part, on relief aspect, I would say people are not getting relief as they are required. Like in these days, the family court are exempted. Those people are many of the girls are maintenance facing child custodies, domestic violence. These are not effectible these days. Only the stay applications and the bail application, these things are working present days, but rest of the things are compromising.
So can we say that virtual courts are moving towards the moot court competitions, thus almost on the similar format for the paperless moot courts?
No, I couldn't say it's quite differ, because the moot court is like we are presenting a story. But in the real virtual court, we are for the particular bail application of particularly property. So on the meanwhile, we are getting relief only the 45 days for my client of bail, and 40 days injunction, temporary injunction in the favor of my client till the notice to serve to the other respondent parties. So it's not as easy, and I would say it's quite difficult for the people, those who are actually in need of the justice. So somehow on the part from the last few months, we are compromising justice for the people. So we are unable to answer to our client. And even in large, I would say people are actually in trouble for the justice criteria. But getting the virus is quite better than the sitting at home with some complications. And that's right, why.
Very true. Very true. So, long back, like few years back, I organized a moot court competition with the state, with a moot problem, having a discussion on that odd-even case, which was, ultimately put like the odd-even rules, which was put by Arvind Kejriwal in the court, in the city, Delhi. So now that competition helped us to generate a report, which was submitted to the Supreme Court of India, so that they can give a proper, from the student point of view, they can give an unbiased decision on that particular case. What do you think? Does this moot court competitions help such events to, help Supreme Court or High Court or Session Courts, trial courts, to pass on their judgments if we submit them a proper report?
No, actually, Sahil, I would say state government have their own inherent power for the particularly criteria of traffic. And in general, for the some of the rule, whatever the High Court and the Supreme Court suggest for us, that was that always discussed by the state government. So in that part, they have their inherent own power. So they can change the traffic rules for the odd and even. No one can stop them. But some on certain part, if the people are some of the in medical country medical emergency, and I don't have even car, so I'll use my odd car. If I have the challan, so I'll narrate to the my problem to the police officer, those who are stopping to me, and they are showing me that I am using my odd number. But some of the guidelines was issued by the state government also in case of emergency of medical and some other reasons, like some like death cases and some other like child illness. So they are exempted in that part. So I don't need, I don't think so, as the mood code can be suggested, because the in general life, people life is quite struggling, and every aspect of the odd and even. I have seen number of cases which the like the media had presented. The people are facing so and so due to the odd and even. So that was the adjustable, because some on the part, state government gave the some relaxation to that peoples, those who are unadjustable for that situation. But in the normal life, those who are just enough for their luxury, just I have the odd number card, but I will use my even also. So the traffic and some other part of the state government is using it, it's quite good for the pollution level also, and they, I think the carpooling aspect has come out from that odd even, right. So it will be quite economical and resistance for the pollution, and the people interaction was quite increased that days, and even the people are sharing their cars and cabs for the going to office and maybe the college and some school lives also,
right.
So I think it was good, not bad for the people, and that don't need any moot court for that.
it helped a lot of entrepreneurs to come up with a lot of ideas to create a lot of applications where people can actually carpool.
Right.
So what according to you are do's and don'ts in the moot court competition for law students?
It's not a do's and competition, I won't say. It's like, it's an imaginary. Like we always in our childhood, we heard some of the fairy tale news, fairy tale stories from our parents, grandparents. It's like a fairy tale. I it's my personal word, which I use for the moot court. It's like a fairy tale. Because in the real court, it's drastic and quite different, where the court and the judge's reaction will be different. Because in the moot court, we have our college professor, maybe the some student, those who are performing judge's role. But it's in reality is quite different. So I would say moot court is like a fairy tale, nothing else. Just an example for the student, like you will face in the future this court life. Otherwise, moot court is not that much helpful for the students, because for that they have to go in a court. I would suggest for a trial court.
Okay. So that was something. I mean, students will actually. I hope students do not take it that seriously that they don't take part in the competition. They should actually.
No, they should participate for the learning aspect. They should participate. But that is not the end of the learning. So sometimes the people, sometimes students got that like. We had done enough our moot court, so we don't need to go for the trial court, and we should enjoy our vacations from the semester end. So we don't need to go some practical knowledge from the court. So it's like in the law field, I had complete my 10 years, as I earlier told to you, but it's daily learning aspect for me. Daily, I'm learning new things from the court proceeding. And new aspects of judges and reaction towards the same sections, they differ and their opinion are quite different. So daily learning aspect, right. I think it's real court is quite better than the moot court.
Okay. I mean, I did not get a chance to practice in the court. I mean, I keep myself away from that. So I won't comment on that.
No, actually.
So, yeah.
I would say some of the people, those who are... quite interested in a corporate arbitration proceeding, so the enlargement international arbitration proceeding. So that criteria of student don't need any trial court proceedings, because there is no trial. People get their solution through the agreement and just for the mediator and arbitration cell, they go and sorted out their solutions, but they don't need any trial court. But if you are trying to be a lawyer, then you should know every part of or segments of the practice field of the law.
Right. So how would you suggest our audience today for when it comes to research? So what all they should keep in mind while researching for even for their competition, for their moot courts, or in general as well?
I would say like research is like you are working on it, some particular theory and some particular aspect of question for the students. In research work, we get a lot of judgment on particular case, like if I have robbery case. So robbery case, I have the number of things, like I had got relief in my appeal last month, where was the just a robbery for the 250 rupees. And they faced 4-year punishment because I was not lawyer in the trial court, I was in appeal. So just on a currency note, we cannot say they had robbed, because 250 rupees everyone can afford in their pocket. So, and if the robbery is like a 1 crore 50 lakh, so everyone cannot carry their 1 crore 50 lakh in their car and their pocket. So difference of the facts of the case. So research is always required. So I would say in the moot court aspect, research is quite helpful for them, because in real court, we will be in a rush and we have number of cases. We have to learn so many proceedings and our entire day spent in the manual work to arguing the people, dealing with the client, drafting work. So in the moot court, whatever we do, our research work, that is very helpful in real court when you face through the real court. So that of your research is very important if you had done in your college life.
All right. So they should more focus on primary research or secondary research?
I would say primary or secondary. I would say both of them is quite required.
Okay. Okay. So while preparing their memorandum from defendant side or like respondent or another side, what they should keep in mind? How should they actually start preparing their memo? From where they have to start or from where they have to end? Right.
First of all, they have to just summarize their case from where it is started and where we will end our case. Then each and every fact of the case, then go to the issues, then the defense of mind, where we are defending our the allegation which is meant by the plaintiff side. So we can defend with our documents through our reply, then we'll end our entire proceedings and arguments on the plaintiff arguments, plaintiff presentation of case against of us, then our defensive documents and our reply and each and every law and minor like judgment, as you research, as you said, the research is quite required. So number judgment is also attached with your final argument. So we can lead through each and every stage of our case. Then we should come out in our conclusion from our side. Like if I'm presenting defendant, then I'll present the entire side of my client, like defense issues, whatever the framework against of me, and my counterclaim. If like a plaintiff had filed case against of me, then I'll go for the counterclaim if I am facing so. And in the case, if I won the case, then I'll able to get the compensation, because unnecessarily I am facing the court proceedings and my time and my lawyer fees is I'm spending. So in the case, if you are defending, then you should keep in mind, you have to claim each and everything, whether you are get or not, but that should be in your defense.
Right. So we have a very interesting question from our audience by Abhay Pratap. In more than 3 years punishment, can we go to both the court session and high court one after another if one court denies bail?
Fine. Yes. If the MM court is denied for the bail, then in the meanwhile, you can go for the session court. The session court can grant a bail, but on the first instance, if the law says, first of all, the lower division is liable to entertain your bail application, your civil petition, your family dispute, everything is required for state is lower court. Then you can go the session or higher court.
Okay. So can we appeal against rejection of bail application?
Sure. No, there is no appeal is required. If your bail application has been dismissed by the session court, then you can proceed with the high court. The high court will grant you with some limitation and time, then you will able to get your relief from the court.
Okay. So we have another question from Kaushik. How to effectively liaise with police authorities based on the Arnesh Kumar judgment?
Sorry, can you read out again?
So how to effectively liaise with police authorities based on the Arnesh Kumar judgment.
Sorry, I'm not familiar with this judgment, so I'll be unable to answer this question.
Definitely. So we'll Kaushik will provide you with this answer in the discuss section while posting the video. Okay. We have one question from Divya Ratho in Moot Court. How we are supposed to make case in our favor? What all points should be considered?
As I earlier told you, if you are in a civil case, then each and every fact and issue should keep in mind. Your defense document is required, and your defense should be stick on a same point. That should not be changing on every stage of your cases. Then your case will be come out in the counterclaim, and some contradiction will come out in your defense. So before the presenting your defense, then should keep in mind each and every step of your defense should be similar till the end of your case. That is required.
All right. So we have another question from Soumya. How far your moot court experience influence your practice in the court?
It's just on a helping aspect of some basic knowledge, like a courtroom, court presentation. You won't hesitate before the court for getting the adjournment or passover or presentation first day of case. So it's in a like helpful for the first step for a student. They just on reach in a first step in a moot court, and rest of the steps will be phased out if they go to real court.
Okay. So we have another question from Nikita. Is using jargons effective in moot court or actual court?
I would say moot court is quite helpful for that part, but in actual court it's quite different.
Okay. So we have another question from Divya. Just a sec. Can a cross examination be helped to be effective?
Always your cases depend on your cross examination. If your cross examination lacking and you are not able to cross your witness completely each on every aspect of your query, then your case will be just on a flatter, nothing else.
Okay. So another question from Ujwal. Does moot court helps in judiciary also?
No, never. Because in a moot court, we face this practicing aspect where we argue and some other part. But the judicial aspect, you have to judge the people on their particular case. So for that, judicial is quite different than the moot court.
Okay. So we have another question from Abhay Pratap again. Can, just a sec. Okay. Can trial court change investigation authority, like from police to CBI, etc.?
Never. It's not authorized by the any of the judge that they can, even they cannot suggest the police officials to investigate in particular way of the case, because it's an their inherent power of the police officials to investigate their case their own way. But we judges only get their copies of the submission and the lawyer's presentation of in the favor of their client, nothing else. Judge can only judge your particular case on particular submission by the prosecution, nothing else. And the police official's case always present by the prosecution. So okay. Judge cannot grant and even direct them to investigation by the CBI or some other agency on some other way also they cannot suggest.
All right. So we have another question from Prerna. Ma'am, can you suggest points related to encounter by police?
In any counter, we are, as per the part of particular fact of the case is required for the inquiry, like if the some person has been encountered by the police official. So in that part, you have to just fact of your case, then you can go directly to the High Court for the presentation, like some of the encounters are fake. Then in that part, we go for the PIL, for their investigation aspect that they had investigated this case and my client was not involved in that part where the encounter was required. So in that part, PIL is quite helpful for the fake encounters and in these aspects.
All right. So we have another question from Abhay Pratap. After bail, any time boundation to submit charge sheet?
Yes, in every case, even not the bail application, that question is maybe Abhay is quite confusing on that part. If the one case is registered against any of them, whether they had get bail or not. It's an required in a like a murder case. It's quite lengthy and investigation takes time. So in the murder cases, there is a limitation for the 90 days for filing of charge sheet. And in case of some other cases, except this murder case, in other cases, there is a 60 days limitation. If charge sheet has not been filed within a 90 days or 60 days, then the accused, those who are behind the bar, they have liberty to get the bail from the court. On that defense, like police have to file their charge sheet within a 90 days or 60 days, then on that plea, we can get the plea before the court that we need. We are able to get the bail from the court because the entire investigation has been taken the place in that time. But it's an inherent choice of judge that he can pass over the bail application, give the direction to the police officials to presentation of their case, how much investigation is pending against of them. Then it is the up to judge, he grant bail or not.
Okay, so we have one question. I guess this question is out of the topic, but I'll just take it up. It has been asked by Ghansham Goyal. Today, the announcement by Ministry of Finance that a bounce check should be decriminalized. So what would you like me to say?
I cannot say any of this topic because the finance department, whatever they do and they changes their in laws, there is the legislative power. And earlier we were dealing as like a criminal proceeding. It's a summary trial proceedings, not I would say a criminal. It's a summary trial proceedings where the negotiable instrument is effect. So changing in every part of investigation or in not investigation, I wouldn't say law changes by the ministry. So it's their inherent power and they have changes. Changes has been come out for us. Then we will face it like that.
Right. So we have another question from Nikita. Is this principle effective if you can't convince the judge, confuse the judge?
Yes. Yes. This principle effects. If you can't convince the judge and you can confuse the judge on all of your story, all strength of your defense, because sometimes we don't have the conclusively result from the prosecution and the defense. So on that part, some like a presumption by the court, it's an inherent power of the court. On presumption of the court, the confusion is always work out.
All right. So this was really an interesting question. I hope no judges in the audience with us.
No, they are very well aware about it because they face mainly in their court proceedings.
All right. So we have another question from Soumya. What will be your suggestion, ma'am, for a person to build their CV and after 5-year course for a better legal future?
There is no criteria for the filling their CV for the better criteria of the law field, because it depends up to you where you go and where you learn and how much opportunity you can enlarge for yourself of your work. It's depend up to that, not a CV.
So frankly speaking, Soumya, don't focus on building your CV, focus on building your knowledge, focus on building your experiences, your CV will automatically gonna build.
100%.
So start doing a lot of online courses, start reading a lot of books, articles, not only from the law field, but from the other field as well, and start actually getting practical internship, which will help you to gain the practical experience in the industry. So I hope, ma'am, this is like the only way we can move ahead right now.
Right, absolutely.
Yeah. So we have another question again from Abhi Pratap. If defense lawyer asked to trial judge to change investigation authority, can judge do then?
And I already answered this question. It cannot be. If the judge cannot give direction to the police official, the direction of investigation, then how is able they can move this court to any other investigation agency? It depends upon the case.
All right. So we have another question from Himanshu Joshi. How is moot court beneficial for us? This question was initially
quite
answered in the
question, as we had already answered it.
Right. So it is beneficial for you to actually learn the practical aspect of the court system, but not the actual aspect of the court system, and helps you to build your confidence. how to actually present your case in the court. So we have another question from Divya Rathore. In moot court, how to start our case? How to present ourselves in the moot court case?
Always the beginning is the first point and impression before the court. It's quite prevalent statement in every lawyer's mind. As I already told, for the presentation of the case, first of all, speak about your case name, then your case detail, what the prosecution or plaintiff had allegated against of you, then your issues, whatever the issues has been framed, whether the charge is framed or issues are framed, civil and criminal, criminal is like a charge and in civil is like an issue has been framed. So it depends presentation of the fact of your case, then start your all the defense and document.
So ma'am, is it mandated by Ghanshyam Goyal? The question is, ma'am, is it mandatory to submit charge sheet within 60 days or 90 days?
Yes, it's mandatory and it is written. And if they are not able to file the charge sheet within a 90 days or 60 days, then they should or must have to explain their incapabilities before the judges that what the time is required. Because sometimes the forensic report and the some criminals is like absconding from the local jurisdiction. They move to some other country, some other state. They hide themselves. So in that part, they have to present before the court, like why they are taking so much time.
Right. So ma'am, we have another question from Prerna. Ma'am, can you just give some ideas that whether memorial writing helps making actual petition?
Sometimes it helps because some of the facts on some of the judgments can change the your presentation. Is defense is stand upon it. So like I give the example, like Talwar family had faced the murder trial and Manu Sharma trial has been taken by Sumoto by the High Court. So many of the landmark guidelines, judgments has been built by the Supreme Court and High Court in that tough like of cases. So we always get the relief from that guidelines or research work and some of the judgment, whatever we are in pleading in our cases. So it's helpful if we are working upon it.
Right. So another question is from Nikita. Does internship uplift the legal scenario for a person going in litigation?
Yes, it's always uplift the confidence of the every law student. Those are going to the internship, but it depend upon the law student who working where. As I already told you, like people always prefer and girls always prefer to going to the High Court just because they had watched some movies and some fairy tale story. So they always go to High Court, Appellate Court, some of the law firms where they cannot get the trial detail and they won't be able to get that confidence, which is in a trial court student of, as I have a number of interns, like I have these days, five interns, those always comes after their semester vacation or after their examination. I can challenge to the anyone of the High Court intern that my interns is quite better than them because they always work upon the research of the case. I just go to the courtroom for the argument. They draft all my petition, defense, every document, attestation, how much court fees is required, and how to deal to file the application, and when it will be listed on the court, and which court jurisdiction is count, and where it will be filed. So that is required for the new advocate to learn the things. So it's very necessary to go to trial court or get some better field for your own self-suggestion and at least learn how where I have to stand.
So ma'am, do you have any availability for the interns right now? We can send you a lot of interns.
No, I have interns. Actually, these days though, we are facing the virtual court, and I would say the coming 3 and 4 months, I don't need required any of the interns because we are not able to go to the court regularly and we are exempted from some part of the work. So right. Whenever it will start, I will welcome to the new new interns. To
guys, the so guys, stay tuned for the internship with Advocate Neetu and stay welcome. In touch. We'll definitely help you to get in touch with ma'am for your internships. So ma'am, we have another question from Kirti. Hello ma'am, I am a 4th year law student. I never participated in moot courts because I don't know much about it. But I have done my internship in district and session court. many times where I learned a lot. So I just want to know, instead of moot court, can we go for good internships where we can gain much knowledge, or moot court is really important?
No, I wouldn't say ki anything is important and another thing is not important, because in a district court, they always stand behind their senior. They cannot argue before the court. But in a moot court, you can present your case by each and every facts, whatever you had learned in the real court. So moot court is also required, where you can build yourself. Like, I can present my case, I can defend my case, I can get the judgment on that part. Because always the student, like those who are intern, they are just not facing argument of their seniors, but they are not presenting their own case. In the moot court, they present their own research work, own field work, entire things. So it's in a confidence built of things, then she should have to face the moot court also.
Okay, right. So we have another question from Pragrati. Ma'am, what is the best way to organize notes related to case?
As I already told our narrator earlier, is that fact of your case. Every case is different, every fact is different. Then your research work is work out, how much judgment you know. And if you are not able to get the judgment, then you can Google and you will find out the judgment similar to that aspect of your case. Each and every fact of your case, your own diary of fact of the case will get you relief in a better way.
Okay, so ma'am, we have a question from Facebook. We are live on Facebook as well.
Okay.
So someone has asked, can the High Court change the investigation agency during investigation upon writ petition? Question has been asked by
Anish. It's an inherent power of High Court. It's an inherent power of High Court. In a session or trial court, I would say that can change the investigation agency. If we go, the writ petition is quite different, the regular petitions or regular trial and charging. It's different. And if you go the writ petition, then you have to prove at least why the investigation should be changed on the suspension of that fact. Or if I would say, it's like for the new student, it's a very wrong idea to getting the change of the investigation agency, because whenever the one FIR has been registered, their inner case diary, their charge sheet, you won't get until and unless their charge sheet has been completed. Or if the further supplementary charge sheet comes out, and if the case is required, then your writ petition will work. Otherwise, writ petition will be dismissed by the High Court and you will get the enlargement of your fine from the High Court. They put a fine of 50,000. Start there from 50,000.
All right. Sort of question, I think, by actually from a student for sure. Shikhar Kumar is asking, ma'am, can you suggest some tricks to answer in the moot court? How smartly we can answer?
You know, I won't say the tricks is required. I had already completed and said, as you, if you had work upon your case, then you don't need any tricks of your smartness. Just gonna go with the case and facts of the case, issues, and your own present of mind, then it will work out.
Okay. So ma'am, we have another question from Divya. If once we submitted memorial, can we change it, or we have to carefully draft a memorial for moot court? And what should be the points be there in the memorial?
Like, as if this question is again and again coming, where we can change and do other thing. As I already said, ki before submitting anything, you just judge yourself wherever you are submitting and what is your defense, what you are doing. That should be very careful, because you are not in a part of joke and casual way, because you are presenting a case, whether it is a moot court or real court. That should be very careful aspect. In the some of the civil courts, in a civil petitions, we have amendment processes. Like, if you do some clerical mistakes and some other topics which we are not able to add, like an adding of party, so their defense and their claim from them, that can be amended. If you are going with the civil proceeding and you are facing in a moot court civil proceeding, then you can amend with the proper order and rule, then able to change it.
Right, ma'am. And Divya, to add on, we are in a profession where one mistake can lead us to, you know, losing of the case.
Right.
So we should be very careful while drafting while what we are researching about and what we are putting on papers. So we have to be very careful. This will be helpful even if you go for corporate, not only for litigation, but for corporates as well. And in any field, I would suggest. So ma'am, we have another question from Anish. What is the best way to read and understand 100 or 200 page judgment? This question I always wanted to ask during my college days, which I could not. So I would love to have that answer.
Like, you know, Sahil, whenever we read out the judgment and we face so many lengthy paragraphs and things, in my own conclusion work, I start from the first para to second para, what was the case and what was their defense and what was the trial had been done and what was the cross-examination. And I go just in a judgment of the trial court. And after that, I start the appellant, their in appellate court, their defense of minor aspects, whatever they had defended in their appeal or revision or review. So we'll just work upon that part of criteria. Our judgment will be in our hand.
Okay. Sorry, Nitika. I took her name Nikita. I just got confused. I'm really sorry. Apologies for that. So she has a question. Is what is procedure for research in the case and what are the sources we can go through for research work and can just elaborate the research tools?
See, whenever you go for the research work, first of all, the basic thing you will have your in hand, whatever you are planning for the research of the things. Now these days is quite easy. We can go through the manual of the other books like CRPC and some other law journals. Many of the judgments are, we get it through the JCC and some of the relevant books are available. And if you are for so advanced level, if you are want to search, then you can go to Manu Patra and go to Google for the proper presentation. Then upon your fact of research, you can work out better way.
Yeah. So we have a very interesting question from Pragati. Can you suggest some points in case the opposition has missed the points?
Always it's work out. Whenever your opposition has not worked upon it, it means you should know about your case. Where you stand, it's important, and where their defense is loses, that will be your plus point. Then you will be able to encash your own case in your favor. Always keep in mind the loose points of other side.
Of course, definitely. I mean, we should always keep in mind what our opponent is going to miss. And or is missing out somewhere, we should always take up that.
Splatter and, entire proceeding of them, if you know the point of them.
Exactly. And that is the one of the quality of a very good lawyer, I would say.
Excellent.
Right. So we have a lot of other questions, ma'am, but due to the shortage of time, we would be putting these questions over the email with you so that you can answer them.
I'll also answer.
Right, and we'll also put the video on our discuss section at Lawyer, you can visit there and you can put all your queries over there and ma'am would love to answer it. So guys, thank you so much for attending, ma'am. Thank you so much for taking out time. I know you were very busy. Yesterday we had a conversation, you were absolutely busy.
Today I'm coming from PR directly.
Right.
Taking out 10-15 minutes late.
Thank you so much, man, for coming and putting so much insightful points for this topic. And the students, I would request you, Lloyd has also taken out internship test for you guys, where you can give that test and while Lloyd helps you to get the required internship accordingly. And this internship will be depending upon your area of interest and helps you to get, intern with the legal professionals in the area you are interested in. So this is an amazing opportunity you guys have. Don't miss this out. For any queries, you can always write us on for law students at lawyer.in, or you can call us on our board number. So our board number is there on the website. You can reach out to us for any further assistance required. Thank you so much, guys, for attending such a wonderful session. Thank you, ma'am, once again. And looking forward for many more sessions like this.
Thank you,
guys. Thank you.
Thank you for inviting me.